Something must be done about this mess.
We need to have something.
What we need is an idea.
That's an idea in itself.
I have a better idea. I'll take a nap and do my best thinking when I sleep.
A nap is a wonderful idea. I would like resting and ready to think about sleep. After all, we are two vehicles separate humans from monkeys.
Maybe I'll take a nap.
Everyone in the village slept through the night and then and a half the next day. When they woke up, a strange old man greeted them.
He stood in front of the newly built hut. There were no rotten fruits lying or on the ground outside or flying buttons around.
Say there, stranger, how is it you have a new house when none was there last night?
And it's so delicious-looking pile of fresh fruit.
Don't tell us you worked all through the night.
No, I slept quite well last night. I didn't have to lift a finger. I would be happy to share my food with you. In fact, I will share my secret with you as well.
The old man picked up a stick from the ground. He brought out a small knife and quickly carved out a figure of a little person with a tail.
Now watch, when I clap my hand, this little figure will come to life.
Everyone? True. To the old man's words, the little figure sprang to life and fit out of him.
This little guy will do whatever you ask, but he can only do one job. You need more figures out of carpet.
The old man waited stick after stick. Dozens of tiny figures, each grinning like mischievous monkeys, stood ready for him.
The lazy villagers were excited about having servants to do all their chores. Everyone except Big Jim. He was worried the old man might think the villagers needed his little people and start charging for the services.
Thank you for your offer, old man. We are quite able to fend for ourselves. However, we are a generous people. If it will make you feel better, we will take a few of your little servants off your hands.
Have as many as you like. It is my pleasure to give you them for free.
Well, then I may be able to use 5 or 6.
I'll take 10.
20 for me.
I'll take 30.
Maybe a few more for me, too. If your little people do all the cooking and cleaning, I'll have time for thinking. That, after all, is what people are for.
Yes, we can spend our time writing down our great thoughts.
We can write poems and make music.
The possibilities are mind-boggling. Right now, my mind is so boggled with all the things I could be doing. I need to take a nap. What a brilliant idea.
See, we're using our brains already. Now, if one of your little people will get help me to my hammock, I'll get to work sleeping.
For the next few days, the villagers were happy. They lay about in their hammocks, thinking great thoughts. The old man's little people did all the chores the lazy villagers would have done if they hadn't been so lazy.
Then the lazy villagers ran out of servants, but they were still many chores to do.
Old man, we do not want you to feel unwanted. To show our generosity, we will accept some more of your little people.
There are two kinds. How many would you like?
Oh, just a few.
100. Nice.
1,000. 2,000.
As quickly as the old man carved new figures, the villagers put them to work. Clap, clap, clap. Little people brought hammocks, fanned away with warm air, and brought the villagers back.
Come alive, little person. I am so busy thinking about the great thoughts I will be thinking. I need you to put a handful of grapes from the bunch, peel them, and put one grape at a time into my mouth.
Lazy head, you are chewing so loudly I cannot continue. Where are you from? Little person over there, come to life and write a poem for me. That's much better. All this clapping has tired me out. Also,
chewing, snoring. How can you expect me to make beautiful music when all this ugly noise? get any rest if I keep waking up. What I really need is one of the little old men to do my training.
Sure enough, with a few more claps, the lazy villagers had a whole village worth of little people just eating their food. First, I have to use my jaw muscles, then I have to swallow. What's worse, my stomach has to digest everything I eat.
Do you think that is tiring? Just thinking about all the thinking have to do is wearing me out.
What are you complaining about? Look at all the breathing I have to do. In and out, all day and all night. It never stops. Not even when I'm sleeping. No wonder I'm so tired. Eating, thinking, are all very tired. What even works me all this complaining? That must be done about even thinking.
The old man put the best food in the room.
It got quiet.